Welcome to the third chapter of the paper Cell Biology. In this chapter, we will learn about the biochemical composition of the cell and the ultrastructure of cell membrane. The biomolecules includes protein, lipids, carbohydrates, and nucleic acids. Metabolic pool refers to all the substances involved in the metabolic reaction in living things. In this session, let us discuss about protein and its structure. Life was a great mystery for common man until the discovery of cell and its components. The cell, which is a basic unit of life, contains various chemical compounds that make up the living organisms and are also essential for their growth and maintenance. These compounds are called the biomolecules. The biomolecules in the cell can be divided into two groups, organic and inorganic compounds. Organic compounds contain carbon, that is, they have a carbon skeleton. Inorganic compounds do not have carbon. The organic compounds present in the cell are protein, lipids, carbohydrates, and nucleic acids. Water is an inorganic compound which is composed of hydrogen and oxygen. Carbohydrates, lipids, and protein function as both fuels and raw materials for building body tissues. Let us discuss about the biomolecules one by one, beginning with protein and its structure. Proteins. The name protein was first suggested by a Swedish chemist, Johannes Jacob Berzelius, in 1838. The Dutch chemist Gerardus Johannes Mulder defined proteins as those compounds without which life cannot exist. He stated that there is present in plants and animals a substance which is without doubt the most important of the known substance in living matter, and without it, life would be impossible on our planet. This material has been named protein. Proteins are most abundant macromolecules connected to all activities of the cell, and it serves as important structural element of the body. Proteins are macromolecules made up of 20 different amino acid residues. Protein sizes range from 40 to 50 residues, which is the lower limit, to several hundred residues depending on their function. They contain thousands of atoms arranged in a 3D structure that is unique for each type and fold itself into a complex 3D shape. This folding of the protein into a specific three-dimensional structure determines the activity of the protein. The specific sequences of amino acid that make up the protein are coded by a gene in the DNA. Protein synthesis is a very complicated process involving the transcription of DNA to RNA, and further this RNA is translated to protein. Since protein synthesis occurs in the ribosome of the cell, they are called as the protein factory of the cell. Each protein formed in the body is unique in its own structure and function and participates in processes that characterize the individuality of cells, tissues, organs, and organ systems. A typical cell contains thousands of different proteins, each with a different function, and they serve as enzymes that catalyze reactions. Some of the proteins transport different compounds either outside or inside cells. Some act as storage proteins, some as defense proteins in blood or on the surface of cells, contractile proteins, and some are merely structural in nature. Let us study about the amino acids, which are the structural unit of proteins. Amino acids. Proteins are made up of 20 different amino acids. Amino acids are organic carboxylic acids in which at least one carbon atom of the hydrocarbon chain is replaced by an amino group. Here you can see the general formula of an amino acid. Typically, an amino acid is a short chain compound with a central carbon atom called alpha carbon. A hydrogen atom, an amino group, a carboxyl group, and a side group are attached to the alpha carbon through covalent bonds. The alpha carbon atom is asymmetrical in that four different groups remain attached to it. The side group is a substitute group and it determines the nature and chemical properties of the amino acid. Amino acids differ from each other only in their side groups. So, there would be as many kinds of side groups as there are different kinds of amino acids. The side groups may range from a single hydrogen atom to a methyl group or to a complex aromatic or aliphatic or heterocyclic chain, often called the R group. In the form of proteins, amino acids comprise the second largest component of human muscles, cells, and other tissues. Outside proteins, amino acids perform critical roles in processes such as neurotransmitter transport and biosynthesis. Amino acids in aqueous solution at neutral pH exist as dipolar, zwitterionic and amphoteric electrolytes. They are said to be dipolar because of two oppositively charged poles. Amino acids behave as anions as well as cations and hence said to be zwitterionic. Amino acids are amphoteric in nature because they have the properties of both acid and alkali. Protein structure. Structural features of proteins are usually described at four levels of complexity. They are primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure. Primary structure is the linear arrangement of amino acids in a protein. Secondary structure is a spatial arrangement of the polypeptide backbone or coiling within a protein by hydrogen bonding to form alpha helices and beta sheets. Tertiary structure is a three-dimensional structure of the entire polypeptide. Quaternary structure refers to the three-dimensional structure of proteins that are composed of two or more polypeptide chains called subunits. Primary structure. The primary protein structure consists of the sequence of amino acid that makes up the polypeptide chain. Here, each amino acid residue is linked by peptide bonds. In this diagram, you can see the peptide linkage between two amino acid residues. Two amino acids can combine together to form a dipeptide by a condensation reaction between the carboxyl group of one amino acid and the amino group of the other amino acid. The resulting bond linking the two amino acids is called a peptide bond. If one more amino acid attached to it via peptide bond, it forms tripeptide. Four amino acids give tetrapeptide and so on. This process is repeated and if more than 10 amino acids are joined through peptide bond, it forms a polypeptide. The polypeptide chain of any length has an N-terminal amino acid with free amino group at one end and a C-terminal amino acid containing a free carboxyl group at the other end. The amino acids in a polypeptide are numbered from the N-terminal end. Since the primary structure has a linear and unfolded arrangement, many structural proteins that form fibers exhibit primary structure. Peptide chain consisting of less than 10 amino acids is known as oligopeptides. The protein may be formed of one or more polypeptide chains. The polypeptide chains are further linked by disulfide bonds. Although the primary structure is known as the simplest level of protein structure, it represents the functional role of a protein. The relative amount of each of the 20 amino acids in a peptide is referred to as the composition of the protein. Each amino acid in a protein is unique and determination of the amino acid sequence is an important part of characterizing proteins. Secondary structure. Protein secondary structure is the second level of protein structure obtained by hydrogen bonding. It refers to the helical nature of the proteins. If the peptide bonds were the only type of linkage present in the proteins, these molecules would have behaved as irregularly coiled peptide chains of considerable length. So, there is a need of regular arrangement of the peptide chains which are obtained by the hydrogen bonding of amino acid residues lying close to each other, forming folding of the polypeptide. Thus, this folding and hydrogen bonding between neighboring amino acids results in rigid and tubular structure called helix. The hydrogen bonds occur between the amide nitrogen and the carbonyl oxygen of the fourth amino acid residue of the polypeptide chain. Secondary structures also have torsion angles between the amino acids. Torsion angle describe the rotations of the polypeptide backbone. They are of three types: the phi angle, psi angle and the omega angle. You can see the torsion angles here. The phi angle is formed around the amino group and the alpha carbon. The psi angle is formed around the alpha carbon and carboxyl group. The omega angle is formed between two amino acids. It is the rotation of peptide bond between carboxyl group and amino group. The torsion angles of a protein structure are studied using the Ramachandran plot. It provides an overview of allowed and disallowed regions of torsion angle and thus serves as an important factor in the assessment of the quality of protein three-dimensional structures. Based on the nature of hydrogen bonding, Pauling and Corey identified two regular types of secondary structure in proteins: alpha helix and beta pleated sheet. Alpha helix. The most common type of secondary structure in proteins is the alpha helix. Here, the polypeptide chain is coiled as a rope wound around a cylinder. The diagram shows the alpha helix held together by hydrogen bonds. So, what do you notice in this diagram? Here, you can see the regular arrangement of the hydrogen bonds. All the NH groups are pointing upwards and all the CO groups pointing downwards. Each of them is involved in a hydrogen bond, and also all the R groups are sticking out sideways from the main helix. Thus, the backbone of the peptide forms the inner part of the coil, while the side chains extend outward from the coil. The helix is stabilized by hydrogen bonds between the NH of one amino acid and the CO on the fourth amino acid away from it. Also, you'll be able to notice that each complete turn of the spiral has approximately 3.6 amino acid residues in it. The helix can be either right-handed or left-handed in the sense of threads on a screw. The naturally occurring alpha helices found in proteins are all right-handed. In helical region of the protein, every peptide bond therefore participates in hydrogen bonding, which leads to a very stable structure. A consequence of the alpha helix is that amino acids apart in primary structure are spatially close to each other in the helix. Hydrogen bonding is strongest when groups are in straight line, which is a configuration in alpha helix. Tight pack within the core of the helix also stabilize the helix. Beta pleated sheet. Hydrogen bonds also stabilize another type of secondary structure in proteins, namely beta sheets. Unlike the alpha helix, the beta sheet is formed by hydrogen bonds between protein strands rather than within a strand. Let us have a look at the diagram. As you may see from the figure, the hydrogen bonds link together different segments of the protein structure. They are not formed between adjacent residues as in alpha helices. Rather, different segments of the amino acid sequence come together to form a beta sheet. Thus, a beta sheet consists of several beta strands kept together by a network of hydrogen bonds. Depending on whether the strands run in the same direction or opposite directions, they are further subdivided into parallel and antiparallel beta sheets. In a parallel chain pleated sheet structure, the N-terminal end of the polypeptide chains point in the same direction, for example, keratin. In antiparallel chain pleated sheet structure, the N-terminal ends of the polypeptide chains point in opposite directions, that is, the amino terminal of one polypeptide is oriented towards the carboxyl terminus of the other polypeptide, example fibroin of silk. Antiparallel beta sheets are slightly more stable than parallel beta sheets because the hydrogen bonding pattern is more optimal. Loops and turn. These are non-regular secondary structures. Most protein contains combination of alpha helices and beta sheets which are connected by different loops. Different forms of loops can be viewed here. Loops have irregular lengths and shapes and are on the surface of the protein. Loop region that connect two antiparallel beta strands are called hairpin loops or turns. Random coil. Besides alpha helix and beta sheet, there exist some random coils. Coils may be due to electrostatic repulsion or bulkiness of R groups that disrupt the structure. Folds and motif. Protein fold refers to the general protein architecture like helix bundle, beta barrel, Rossmann fold or different folds provided in the structural classification of protein database. The structural and sequence motifs refer to short segments of protein three-dimensional structure or amino acid sequence that were found in a large number of different proteins. Tertiary structure of protein. The protein tertiary structure is more complex than the secondary structure. It can be considered as final specific geometric shape that a protein assumes. Tertiary structure described the global conformation of a protein in which the elements of its secondary structure are arranged in space. It is determined by interactions occurring between amino acids which can be long distance apart in the amino acid sequence but which are brought close together in space by the way the protein folds. The tertiary structure is attained by globular proteins. In such cases, the secondary helical structure is further folded to form a globular ellipsoidal shape. The folding is established by the appearance of more disulfide bonds as well as hydrogen bonds, ionic bonds and hydrophobic bonds. Groupings or arrangements of secondary structures in two combinations that are present in a variety of proteins are often described as motifs or domains. As helices and sheets are units of secondary structure, so the domain is a unit of tertiary structure. Myoglobin, ribonuclease, chymotrypsin, cytochrome C, etc. exist in tertiary structure. Myoglobin is abundant in muscles. It contains a single polypeptide chain of 153 amino acids and a single iron porphyrin heme group. The figure shows the tertiary structure of myoglobin protein. Domains. Polypeptide chains of less than 200 amino acids that fold into two or more compact globular clusters are called domains. There are three main types of domains. Alpha domains are composed of alpha helices. Beta domains contain antiparallel beta sheets and usually two beta sheets are packed against each other. Alpha beta domains contain the beta alpha beta motif of parallel beta sheets. Adjacent domains are connected by one or two segments of the polypeptide chain. All globular proteins have a defined structure. In the tertiary structure of proteins, almost all the hydrophobic side chains are found in the interior of the protein and almost all hydrophilic side chains are found on the outside of the protein, interacting with water. Globular proteins are compact and there is no space inside. Hence, water is effectively excluded from the hydrophobic interior. Quaternary structure. Many large proteins contain more than one polypeptide chain. The spatial arrangement of these subunits is the quaternary structure of protein. The forces that hold subunits together are the same weak bonds that stabilize the tertiary structure of protein. Van der Waals and London dispersion forces, salt bridges and hydrogen bonds. The quaternary structure presents itself as an aggregation of two or more polypeptide chains with a tertiary structure organized into a single functional protein molecule. A protein with a quaternary structure is referred to as an oligomer, and its polypeptide chains, the tertiary structure, are referred to as protomers. The contact region between subunits resembles the interior of a protein. The subunits may be identical, but there is always a defined stoichiometry. The protein insulin is made up of two polypeptide chains. Hemoglobin has four polypeptide chains. The quaternary structure is of two types, depending on the nature of the polypeptide chains. They are homogeneous quaternary structure and heterogeneous quaternary structure. In homogeneous quaternary structure, the polypeptide chains are identical. Example, phosphorylase. In heterogeneous quaternary structure, the polypeptide chains are non-identical. For example, hemoglobin. Here are some questions. Explain the various structural features found in protein secondary structure. Explain domain. How is it related to tertiary protein structure? Discuss about the various forces that stabilize the protein structure. Write a note on protein primary structure. Explain amino acids. Make a comparative study on the four protein structure. References: Biochemistry, Donald White, Judith G. White, John Willey and Sons, Incorporated. Biochemistry, Harper's, Robert K. Murray, Daryl K. Graner, Peter A. Mace, Victor W. Rodwell. Fundamentals of Biochemistry, Jane J. L., New Delhi, S. Chand and Company Limited, 1979. Leninger, Principles of Biochemistry, Michael M. Cox, David L. Nelson. New York, W. H. Freeman and Company, 2008. Biochemistry, Dr. L. M. Narayanan and Company, Nagarkoil, Saras Publication, 1994. Outlines of Biochemistry, A Quick Review, Rastogi SC, New Delhi, CBS Publishers, 2003. Here, we conclude the session. We will discuss another topic in the next session. Until then, bye.